to moderate our Q&A. Lisa.
I'm still slightly in shock. I got a phone call at 1 o'clock in the morning in California. I thought about whether I should answer it or not, and luckily I decided I would see who was calling. And I was extremely surprised to get the Nobel Prize in Physics. I never expected that. I'm hoping AI will lead to tremendous benefits, to tremendous increases in productivity, and to a better life for everybody. I'm convinced that it will do that in healthcare. My worry is that it may also lead to bad things. And in particular, when we get things more intelligent than ourselves, no one really knows whether we're going to be able to control them. We don't know how to avoid them all at present. That's why we urgently need more research. So I'm advocating that our best young researchers, or many of them, should work on AI safety, and governments should force the large companies to provide the computational facilities that they need to do that. Okay, so most of the top researchers I know believe that AI will become more intelligent than people. They vary on the timescales. A lot of them believe that that will happen sometime in the next 20 years. Some of them believe it will happen sooner. Some of them believe it will take much longer. But quite a few good researchers believe that sometime in the next 20 years, AI will become more intelligent than us. And we need to think hard about what happens then.
Your Nobel Prize, I'm sure I speak for the entire University of Toronto community.